What is up, Tokusatsu, Super Sentai, and Power Rangers fans? Regan, Wilks, Autism Productions here, that's right, RWAP. Regan, Wilks, Super Lore here, that's right. And today, I'm gonna start trying to explain to you about the new video about the vlog. I was going to tell you that it's about Super Sentai, like how I first time know about Super Sentai, like I'm trying to explain to you. Like I know about Power Rangers back in my childhood days, because Super Sentai was another part of my childhood days, like with DuckTales, VeggieTales, the Wiggles, Disney movies, and all that. Though Super Sentai is the Tokusatsu series by TOEI Company, and both series by Shotaro Ishinomori, as like the Japanese Stan Lee, who is the creator of Kamen Rider Cyborg 2009, which I know like before Spider-Man came to Japan since 1978. So anyways, let's begin the video how I explain about Super Sentai, and let's begin. So my first time watched Power Rangers on the VHS was Mighty Morphin Power Rangers and Dino Thunder, which both of the series are my favorite Power Rangers shows of all time. Well, it was all the beginning of way back in 2010, like it was back in first grade when I was on YouTube, the old version, when I first time watched like one of Spider-Man's nostalgic videos, like parodies and clips and more, even Annoying Orange as well. And the one day, like when I watched like the cutscene of the game and the clips with was Super Sentai, which I know about, like the clip from Hakuchu Sentai Gal Ranger versus Super Sentai with all 24 Red Rangers, and also the PlayStation 1 game was back in Japan was still Hakuchu Sentai Gal Ranger, which before Power Rangers Brawl Wars. And when I was 7 years old, when I thought if Power Rangers was in Chinese, like the clips, like the fighting, the Megazords and monsters and all that too, with like storytelling, but when I was wrong about that, because I know it was Japanese, the original Japanese, which helped inspire the Power Rangers with adaptations, with storytelling, took place, with original themes, with footage and editing, and voicing over like the monsters and even the rangers, with original Japanese footage with the Megazord and the fight scene, and even like different morphing times, like the sequence of Super Sentai and Power Ranger, and all that before 2011. It was like after 2010 I knew about Super Sentai, but before 2011 I was been a huge fan of Super Sentai. When I know there was another video game with also a Japanese arcade, that is Super Sentai Battle Dice O, with that was both with Shinkenger, Joel Anger, and Goldanger, like the furthest game. Like it was like before I know about like more Ultraman and Kamen Rider, and also even like the updated one for Super Sentai Battle Dice O was with DX, the deluxe with Kaitoku Sentai Gokaiger, Tokume Sentai Go Buster, and Ruta Sentai Koryuger. And there was also a Wii game, too, was Super Sentai Battle Ranger Cross. I mean, I've been a fan of all those games. Like, even the Power Rangers games were cool back in the day, like in the 90s. It was really, really cool and nostalgic childhood stuff and all of that, like, you should know, like me. Too. I mean, yeah, like Super Sentai, it's always been a popular thing, like that helped support Power Rangers. I know, like, with Go Ranger to, like, Go Ranger to Go Kaiser was the 35th Super Sentai anniversary from 2011, but the 25th anniversary, that was both with Go Ranger and Gal Ranger, like the movie crossover thing, is before the Power Rangers Wild Force episode Forever Red fighting the evil version of Big Bad Beetleborg. And it was like before that with Gokaiger. I know of like with Mighty Morphin Power Rangers Season 1 reversion, that the 2010 version, like the editing and comic book style, like I remember the toy figures And I know they like to cover like the helmets with Super Sentai Go Danger came out in 2010 with before 2013 Power Rangers Mega Force on Nickelodeon, which I know they like the parodies too, like the animation and like cosplay costumes. I mean, I did watch those old videos back then. It was like way back then when I was a kid. It's how Super Sentai became more popular Tokusatsu with multicolored superheroes that helped inspire the Power Rangers by TOEI and Saban. Even Disney era and Neo-Saban era that was for Nickelodeon and Hasbro era for Nickelodeon and Netflix too. Because I watched some of those episodes of the Power Rangers and Super Sentai. I mean some of the like clips on YouTube though, and when I first time got the first Super Sentai DVD that was this came out in North America by Shout Factory. That was by Saban's brand, that's Neil Saban's era, and Hasbro. Because Zoo Ranger is my favorite show of Super Sentai. That's before Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. I mean, there were these pilots before the whole series began with. Like, I know, like, there was a 1986 on air pilot episode. It's Bioman, which almost like before Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. I know there was like, I did heard about like a few months ago about Taiyosin Taishun Vulcan, which Stanley was trying to do the adaptation of Power Rangers by Marvel Comics. And even though, like with Saban, who is trying to start with Bioman, because Bioman is the 8th Sentai series that has the first female Yellow Ranger, like before the main, before the female White Ranger and Blue Ranger, like which that was Change Man and Life Man. So, and also like a, like I know like when I know all of it because I watch it in subtitles, because I mean super, my favorite Sentai show is Korean Sentai Blue Ranger, like that also combined with three series with Gotei Sentai Die Ranger and Ninja Sentai Tiger Ranger and Mighty Morphin Power Rangers movie. I first time like watched Mighty Morphin Power Rangers the movie, which was really cool with CGI graphics. It was like a little bit of like Sega Saturn designs models, or even like PlayStation 1. Yeah, because I like finished watching all of these Super Sentais on DVDs. It took me from Blue Ranger, Die Ranger, Kaka Ranger, O Ranger, Mega Ranger, Ganga Man, Go-Go 5, Time Ranger, Gal Ranger, Hurricaneer, Jetman, Five Man. I'm still on Deca Ranger, because I will get to the Abba Ranger and Car Ranger, too. And I also finished with RPM and Mystic Force, because RPM and Mystic Force, Dino Thunder are my favorite shows too. And also in 2021, the Super Sentai manga that came out in North America with English text, that was by the Seven Thieves. I mean, I did heard about this since 2020. There's lots of updates with the Spider-Man PS4 game that was only had their own Kamen Rider suit and older remastered version for mobile Spider-Man when Spider-Man Miles Morales came out on PlayStation 5. I mean, it was really cool when I did a review of it last time, because it was a book like rated like how you read it in a, this is a classic manga edition, when it said Satoru Ishinomori's classic manga that helped inspire Power Rangers now in English for the first time ever. On the DVD cover it says, see where the worldwide phenomena begins with the original Japanese series that inspired the Power Rangers franchise. That is, before Power Rangers there was Super Sentai. And I know about like Mighty Morphin Power Rangers Season 2 that only used Die Ranger footage and exclusively Die Ranger's mecha. But before Cosmic Fury came out this year, that was based on Q Ranger with only three monster suits from Duoger and Dino Fury. I mean, Duoger, New Power Ranger vs. Tag Ranger, and even Tokusatsu. I know, like, Tokusatsu villains were used in this video, and Dino Fury only. So, yeah, anyways, thank you for joining how I first time knowing about Super Sentai. That was 13 years ago, back in 2010. So, anyways, if you guys know, hit the like, favorite, comment down below, subscribe, and tap the bell for notifications, and then I'll leave you a video later for more videos, explaining, and vlogs. And peace out for Super Sentai!